The idea had always been there. What pressures, what forces had exerted themselves on him to rise to such eloquence? And it turns out that this period, from the first day he becomes prime minister, and he was a compromised choice as a prime minister. Nobody really thought he had it in him to lead the country at all, let alone in its gravest crisis. But he turned himself sort of within 4 weeks into the Churchill we know. So that involved a lot of reading and stuff. But most dauntingly, and a bit like Gary, I suspect, as hard as it is to play him, it's extremely daunting to write for Winston Churchill. He could string a word or two together, that man. And they were very big sort of literary shoes to fill. So that was the big challenge for me. He's often portrayed as a sort of caricature, I've always felt, and not enough justice has been done to his sense of humour, which he believed was an essential element of seriousness, that you couldn't actually claim to be a very serious person unless you understood comedy and humour. And he really used humour as an agent for change, as if a difficult message, if coated in honey, would be swallowed. So he saw humour and language as an incredible agent. And he was primarily a writer. He was first a journalist. He, at the end of his life, he had written more than Shakespeare and Dickens combined. So he believed in the very core of his very poetic soul that words could be enlisted to change the world. And that was certainly my entry point into him. The other thing is that modern scholarship is sort of revealing a more three-dimensional Churchill than we've seen before, and I hope this film does something to contribute to that, because he's always been presented someone who brooked no doubt, who was always popular, a man who knew his own mind and never wavered. And when I dived into the research, and it's all available online, these are the minutes of the War Cabinet meetings conducted in these very, very trying months, it reveals a very different Churchill than we've been led to believe. He is a man who changed his position on subjects, on critical subjects, such as doing a peace deal with Hitler, by the day and sometimes by the hour. And it really begged the question, is what drove him to shift his position in this wavering period? And it is my conclusion, and I think the conclusion of us all, that this period of wavering, rather than be a negative, is actually an incredibly positive aspect of leadership. In fact, a prerequisite for great leadership is to be able to consider opposite points of view, to take a period of where you get out of your own dogmatic position, take the opposite point of view, sit with it, live with it for a beat or two, synthesize those different opinions, sometimes polar opposite opinions, and then come up with your decision. And that seemed to be the journey that Winston made in making himself the great leader he became. And it's the sort of thesis of the film, which I think is news.